of $1,500 per hectare. His expected in, expected expenses in the coming years have obviously dropped. So what are the characteristics of a smart farmer? Anyone can be like Mark Orlando. To become a smart farmer, you must be, you must have the desire to improve your operation for self, community, and the environment, knowledgeable in reporting and using data to operate the technology, have the wisdom in using technology to improve farming operation. But before we learn how to use new technology, it is important for the farmers to understand what data is and its benefits. So now I'm going to discuss the power of data. What exactly is data? It consists of facts, statistics, and other things that can be processed as information. So examples of farming data, the kind of seed quality, the soil quality, amount of water, fertilizer type, pests and diseases, location and kinds of weed, weather, and the number of buyers. These are just some of the, these are just few of the many examples of data being used in farming. Okay. When we have the data, it is easier for us to decide what to plant, where, when, and how to plant it. So examples, when we know which is the best quality seed, that is what the farmers buy. When we know the current quality of the soil is, the farmers can easily decide whether it should be planted, rested, or what can be planted in it. When the farmer knows how much water is available, he can estimate which part of the land to reach when he finds another source of water. So data being used, is being used to operate the technology. Examples of data. When we input our preferred seed variety and condition of the soil into an AI, it can recommend a suitable seed variety to the farmer. Once a farmer knows the exact size of his land, he can plant and fertilize it using the drones. When he knows the appearance of a weed to an AI, or when he shows the appearance of a weed to an AI, it can identify the type of weed and recommend an appropriate solution. So technology is also used to facilitate data acquisition and processing. When we deploy sensors, it can monitor water, nutrient, pests, and diseases out in the field. When we use the Internet of Things to capture data on various resources, it can track your consumers' thoughts and actions. So the power of youth. What if a farmer is not very data and technology savvy? Because as farmers age, new technologies exist, they continue to proliferate, and it's a bit difficult for farmers age 55 and above to keep up with the modern technology. So this is where the youth comes in. Where do the youth come in? The young people are generally considered digital natives, we call them in the Philippines. They are people who were born in the technology century and grew up skilled in it. They use technology for operational data. They can use technology to facilitate data acquisition and processing. The youth can contribute to the development of their area and country using agriculture and technology. So they can use digital platforms to promote farming and related innovations. They can also develop their own technology and share it with the farmers. They can adapt or help their community use them, this technology to improve the farming operations. So we have a few examples of model youth in the Philippines. So one is Junrey Penafidel. He's a 27-year-old farmer, very young farmer from Maguindanao. He was able to harvest 12 metric tons of rice per hectare using the hybrid rice variety as provided by the Department of Agriculture under the hybridization program.
Just one example.
Another one is Elvin Jerome Laceda. He is the CEO of Rice Up Farmers, a very young entrepreneur. Rice Up Farmers Incorporated is an award-winning social enterprise that educates farmers about innovative technology development and farming. So they are just a few of the youth who are now engaged in agriculture as well as modern technology. Okay, so how does a farmer prepare? So first, he would have to check his seed quality and his land preparation. So it all starts with choosing the right variety of seeds. What happens when we don't choose the right seeds? It will not grow. It will be susceptible to pests and diseases. It may not be weather tolerant. And definitely, the farmer cannot increase his yield. So how to choose the suitable seeds? It has to be location specific. It has to be suitable to his location, to his environment, season, and crop establishment. So how can a farmer know all of this? By using the Pinhing Palay app. This is a mobile application that was developed by Philrice together with Erie. It has the complete list of different rice varieties available in the Philippines. It is free to download from Google Play and can be used without internet connection.
Oh, good.
So
English.
Some of the features of Pinhing Palay app is you will be able to search different kinds of rice varieties that you would want to plant, and you can immediately see where it is suitable to plant. You can also search for popular rice varieties often used by farmers. You will also find rice variety that will be suitable to the location, environment, season, and crop establishment. So these are just some of the features of this mobile application that many farmers in the Philippines are now using. Management of rice crop. So rice plants normally go through a very long process of growth, and in that process, it is important that farmers take care of the nutrient and health of the rice plant. So how are they going to check on the health and vigor of the rice plant? By using another mobile application, which is the Leaf Color Computing app. So this is another application. This one you can also buy. This is not free from Google Play, but after downloading, you can use it without the internet. So it is a mobile application that checks the nitrogen level of the rice plant. It would cost between $2 to $3 when you download it. But again, the beauty of it can be used without Wi-Fi or internet connection. Some of the features of the LCC, you can input your farm profile and some of the common types of rice varieties that they normally grow. You can scan a leaf by taking a picture of the rice leaf to check its nitrogen level. So normally, you can just bring your mobile smartphone out of the field, take random samples of the leaves, and then it will give you a recommendation of how much nutrigen is needed by the managing pests and diseases. So how do we know, how do farmers know if their rice plant has a disease or pest? There are several applications also developed by a private company in partnership with DOST Picard, Erie, and Philrice. So we call it PRIME, or Pest Risk Identification and Management. So basically, the purpose of PRIME is to identify the risk factors of pest outbreaks, max potential outbreak risk, and formulate integrated pest management strategies using field-based pest surveillance information derived from the satellite images and pest risk modeling. It aims to improve the rice productivity, welfare, and competitiveness of Filipino farmers by avoiding the risk of major pest outbreak, which fortunately for us in the past 3 or so years, there has not been any major pest outbreak in the country. Another web-based application is the RC Master, or the Rice Crop Management Advisory System. It can be downloaded free from Google Play and also does not need internet to operate.
Okay, the rice crop manager advisory rice crop manager advisory services is a free app that provides recommendation about the farm's potential nutrient management plan. It can give the following recommendation: what, when, and how much fertilizer should be used, when should an insecticide or pesticide should be used, the correct amount of water at each stage of the rice plant growth. So features of the RC Mass, farmer, and the farmland information. So it has to be inputted or registered into the app. You can also upload the size and appearance of your farm through the GPS system. It will generate recommendations to the farmer on different nutrient management of their farm. But before using the RC Mass property, a farmer has to know the exact size of his farm. Because generally in the Philippines, a farmer does not really know the exact size of his farm, of his farmland. And it is quite expensive to hire a geodetic engineer to do the survey. Normally, we would use a Garmin GPS receiver tool.
Garmin GPS.
What the farmer has to do is to, the unit is also expensive. So most farmers cooperative are encouraged to have this type of equipment so that members can borrow, so that they would have the exact farmland size. Now, for the weed management, there are various types of weeds, and sometimes it confuses the farmers what kind of weed is in their farmlands. Okay, so if there's a lot of weed, rice plants will lose their much needed nutrient because they will take away the nutrients from the rice plant. The grains will be of low quality, and the cost for labor will increase. So we have this mobile application developed again by the government, which we call eDamuhan. This app quickly identifies the weeds and find possible solutions to get rid of them. Again, it is free to download on Google Play. It can be used without the internet. But the beauty of this application is that you just need to take a photo of the weed that
in Philippine develop a lot of
The kind of weed and the kind of weed that we have, and it will give out recommendations on how you can manage the growth of the weed. So you can also upload just a picture using your gallery, phone gallery. So it lists the different types of weeds, available herbicides that is on the market, and which type can be used and how it is applied. So with the eDamuhan application, you can take quick action because you already know the type of weed. Then we also have other rice applications being used by the farmers. So we have this Plant Doctor. It is a website that provides breeders, researchers, field technicians, and farmers a quick diagnostic guide for the most common vegetable diseases. This app was developed by a private company. So with the help of a plant doctor, farmers can easily find out what diseases their crops have, and they will know how to treat it. Speed Tech, developed by smarter approaches to reinvigorate agriculture as an industry in the Philippines. This one is funded by the DOSTP card. So Speed Tech is an app used for digital pest and disease identification. It provides a faster method of pest monitoring in different areas in the Philippines for different agricultural industries. Okay, MOEP, or the minus one element technique, is a mobile app where the farmer can calculate the appropriate amount of field fertilizer that he can use in his paddy field. The MOEP can also help predict the rice yield for your fertilization plan. So this is how a MOEP works.
Minus one element technique.
Thank you.